Hey y'all. So over here, I think we have our site where I want to do a little cabin. So my game plan is, or what I'm thinking of right now, is to do like a little outdoor kitchen, outdoor cooking with a room, and then put a cabin right there. I'm even considering building or digging down and putting a root cellar. So that way, because I'm not going to have power back here. Now, eventually I may try to do solar or something like that, but I don't know. But I think in-ground root cellar would be pretty good, especially with, there's a little bluff right there that drops down into the hardwood bottom. So we have the hardwood bottoms down there, the drainage way, and then up the land goes up as we go south. So the north side is that way, the south side is that way. So water comes down this way, there's a drop right there. So if I could dig down and then have a outlet coming out, so if I do get water or drainage in there, it can easily drain out into the bottom down there. So that's just some of the things I'm considering. I'm gonna get in here and just clean all this out. One of the reasons I like this spot is if north is kind of at an angle that way, and so south is right behind me. So a lot of these pines, it's more open in the piney woods. Not only that, but some of those pines are what I will cut down and mill to build the little cabin. So I want to clear out some of the south side, so in the winter the south exposed sun will be shining, I'll be getting light from that. In the summertime, when the sun is highest in the sky, I'll be over the underhang of these oak trees, so I'll get some overhead shade. The north side is completely blocked, so any north wind during the winter time will pretty much be blocked coming in. On the east side, it's a little more open, which I like because I like the morning sun as the sun comes up, especially during the summertime. And on the west side, as the sun starts to set, or really right here under these oaks about midday on, this will all be shaded because the sun, it'll be behind a canopy the whole time. So looking at all that, I think this is a pretty good spot. It's centrally located, so it's almost right in the middle of the property, which is good. You know, we got a trail right through here. We have two trails going down. One right down there, another one, the one to the east, one to the west. So I think it's a pretty good spot to play around and build a cabin. So I'm gonna start just cleaning up, just going through by hand and getting some of this stuff out the way, just looking at the contours. Eventually I'll come in here with a bush hog and cut a lot of this, but I wanna get in here by hand and clean up some stuff and look at it. So that's what we're doing right now.
water for the dogs.
Oh, no.
look for Andy. Where y'all at? There y'all are. All right.
So on the smaller trees, I think I prefer to do a lot of limbing with just by hand. For one, that chainsaw is it's a decent sized saw. So, and yes, it does make quicker work of cutting the limbs, but hey, I gotta sit there and tote it around. Actually physically enjoy doing this as well. And plus, to me, it's a little more calming than the constantly having a saw running. And it takes a little longer, but to me, it's a little more enjoyable. So that's why I'm just hacking these manually. I know a good bit of these right here are going to be too small to mill, but I'm still going to cut them in, I think, in 8-foot lengths. So I think what I'm going to do on some of these smaller ones is try to use them as fence posts and whatnot, or garden structures,
building material just for posts.
No, I don't have a fancy lumberjack measure.
That's where I'm gonna go 10. I might actually be able to get a decent post out of this one. Maybe even 12. Glad nothing's happened to my right hand, because I'd be in a bind doing everything left-handed.
one's over with. Gonna help me pick these sticks up? Not gonna help me pick these sticks up? You don't like the big sticks?
So one thing too is adjust this. So one thing is I'm trying to be a little more methodical and not my typical just start without thinking through the process. And I'm, like I said, I'm not a professional sawyer, I'm not a professional lumberjack, I'm not a professional lumber miller or conservationist or anything like that, so I'm learning as I go. And I enjoy doing some of this by hand. First of all, I'm 50 years old. I need to continue to push myself physically within reason. So plus it gives me a opportunity to think as I go, because I'm gonna have to make something to start putting these logs on, because I can't just leave them on the ground. I'm gonna have to skin them, and then after I skin them, I'm gonna try to make a fire and burn them, and then oil them if I'm gonna use them as post, so that way they'll be protected. So the smaller ones, putting in another stack, those will be kind of, you know, for garden stakes and whatnot. So once again, trying to make use of what I have and conserve as much as I have. And I got gloves right there on that tractor, which is not bad. It's just some of that bark had a couple of sharp spots on it. But let me go put my gloves on and clean this. So if you do cut yourself and you're working around pine trees such as I am, you can take that pine sap and rub it on there first. It acts like a band-aid, because the pine will dry and get sticky and seal it. Secondly, pine sap naturally is, I guess, antibiotic or antifungal, because that's the tree emits the sap whenever it has a wound. So it's very, very good to put on cuts and whatnot. So that's what I did, rub some sap on it. And of course, you know, if you just put on a pair of gloves, you shouldn't have to worry about that so much. While I'm putting these on, I do want to say I've been a long time follower of Wrangler Star, and turning your leather gloves inside out is literally a game changer for wearing gloves. That's what I said. I had these on my tractor, and of course I hate gloves, but wearing them like this is beneficial indeed. So I have to make myself continue to wear them and try to take better care of myself, since I am out here by myself. Anyhow, pine sap.
Oh,
Good boy, good girl. Thank y'all for listening. Yes. Thank y'all for listening. All right.